Apple just rolled out the M5 chip across its Pro lineup. Now in the 14-inch MacBook Pro and the latest iPad Pro. But does this new silicone really transform both, or is it mostly marketing sparkle? Apple claims 3.5 times faster AI, higher memory bandwidth, and boosted graphics across both machines. Here's what matters. Can the MacBook and iPad actually deliver those gains in real use? Are they now in comparable powerhouses or just incremental upgrades over the M4? We'll test benchmark numbers, application stability, sustained performance, thermals, and day-to-day feel across both devices. By the end, you'll know whether M5 makes both machines feel like different classes or merely slightly faster versions of what we already know. Ready to see which device benefits most and whether it's worth upgrading either? Let's go. The new 14-inch MacBook Pro is here, complete with Apple's most powerful chip yet, the M5. But here's the twist. Despite the new brain inside, everything on the outside feels very familiar. Set the 2025 M5 MacBook Pro beside last year's M4 version, and you'd be hard-pressed to tell them apart. Same aluminum body, same 3.4-pound weight, same 0.61-inch slim chassis, even the color options, silver and space black, haven't budged. The 14.2-inch liquid retina XDR display also remains identical, offering that sharp 3,024 by 1,964 resolution and mini LED brilliance. But honestly, that's not a bad thing. Last year's panel already delivered near OLED contrast and top-tier HDR, so there wasn't much room to improve. And if you're wondering about the keyboard or trackpad, yep, they're the same too. Apple's if it ain't broke, don't fix it philosophy is alive and well here. The keys still offer that crisp 1mm travel, and the Force Touch trackpad remains one of the best in the business. So what's new? Not the body, it's what's inside that matters this year. When it comes to connectivity, Apple seems to be playing it safe, or maybe just keeping things consistent. The 2025 M5 MacBook Pro carries forward the exact same port setup we've seen for the last few years. That means your familiar MagSafe 3 charging port, 3.5mm headphone jack, HDMI output, and SDXC card reader all remain right where you expect them. It's comforting, sure, but not exactly thrilling. Many were hoping Apple's upgraded 150GB per second bandwidth on the M5 chip would usher in the Thunderbolt 5 across all models. Unfortunately, that's not the case. Just like before, Thunderbolt 5 support is still reserved for the higher-end Pro and Max variants. So, while the port's lineup continues to deliver reliability and versatility, there's no real surprise here. The M5 MacBook Pro keeps the same dependable connectivity, but no bold moves this time. So the winner is no one here in this case. On the software side, Apple has always blended polish with power, and the new M5 MacBook Pro is no exception. Last year, the 14-inch MacBook Pro shipped with macOS Sequoia 15.1. which brought some handy upgrades like split-screen management, presenter controllers for video calls, and a few quality-of-life tweaks to built-in apps. But the biggest innovation? Apple Intelligence, Apple's on-device AI toolkit. Now with the M5 MacBook Pro, macOS Tahoe takes Apple Intelligence to the next level. Developers can tap into stronger on-device AI capabilities for apps, automating tasks like parsing data from files dropped into specific folders. Live translation comes to messages, FaceTime, and phone, both text and audio, making global communication seamless. And it's not just AI under the hood. Tahoe introduces Liquid Glass, a fresh visual design that adds transparency to icons, widgets, and menu bars, creating more usable screen space while looking modern and sleek. Older M4 MacBooks will see most of these updates too, but the enhanced Apple Intelligence features truly shine on the M5 hardware, making it the smarter machine for developers and power users alike. So the winner is Apple MacBook Pro 14-inch M5. Now let's get to the heart of the 14-inch MacBook Pro, the M5 chip. This is where Apple's latest generation really flexes its muscles. Like previous models, the M5 is a full system on a chip, integrating the CPU, GPU, neural engine, and unified memory on a single die. But don't let that familiar structure fool you. The 10-core CPU keeps the same 4 performance cores and 6 efficiency cores as the M4, built on Apple's refined 3rd generation 3-nanometer process. but the GPU is where the magic happens. Apple has re-engineered the GPU architecture, added third-gen ray tracing, and, this is huge, included a neural accelerator in every graphics core. What does that mean in real terms? Rendering is faster, graphics are smoother, and AI tasks that once needed cloud processing, like summarizing documents or generating images, can now run directly on your MacBook. Apple claims massive gains here. Up to 45% higher graphics throughput and a four-fold increase in AI performance compared with the M4. That makes the M5 MacBook Pro a powerhouse not just for creatives, but also for developers and anyone experimenting with on-device AI. With all that extra horsepower under the hood, you might expect the battery to take a hit. Surprisingly, Apple says the M5 MacBook Pro still delivers up to 24 hours of mixed-use battery life, matching the M4. Thanks to efficiency improvements in the 3-nanometer architecture, even heavy workloads are expected to be more power-friendly, allowing you to push this machine hard without constantly hunting for an outlet. In short, the M5 isn't just about raw speed. It's about smarter, faster, and more capable performance without sacrificing endurance, keeping the MacBook Pro portable and reliable for a full day of work, play, or creative projects. The M5 MacBook Pro doesn't just stop at faster processing and AI. Storage gets a serious upgrade too. The new SSDs are twice as fast, meaning apps launch quicker, files load almost instantly, and energy efficiency improves, which also helps when running local AI models, including Apple Intelligence or your own LLMs. And if you need space, Apple has doubled the top-tier storage from 2 TB to 4 TB, giving professionals plenty of room for massive projects. Of course, doubling storage comes with a price, an additional $600 for the 4 TB configuration, but for heavy users, it's worth the investment. Speaking of price, the base 14-inch MacBook Pro with M5 remains at $1,599, the same as last year's M4 model. Upgrade options like extra memory, nanotextured glass, or larger SSDs will increase the total cost, but the starting point is unchanged, making this refresh accessible to anyone looking for top-tier Apple silicone in a familiar package. All told, Apple has played it smart. On the outside, the MacBook Pro looks identical to the 2024 model, so no one will be alienated by radical design changes. But inside, it's a different story. Faster CPU and GPU performance, unprecedented AI capabilities, snappier storage, and all of it while maintaining the same impressive battery life. The M5 14-inch MacBook Pro isn't just an upgrade. It's a subtle, powerful evolution, giving users more speed, smarts, and room to work without sacrificing anything that already worked. And now, we shift gears to see how the iPad Pro M5 stacks up against its M4 predecessor. Can Apple bring the same performance leap and AI capabilities to a tablet form factor? And does it make the iPad a real contender for professional workflows? Let's find out. After exploring the MacBook Pro, let's shift to the iPad Pro, where Apple has also introduced the M5 chip. On the surface, the new 13-inch iPad Pro looks almost identical to the 2024 M4 model. The dimensions, weight, and screen size, 13 inches with a crisp 2752 by 2064 resolution, remain unchanged. In fact, if you place the two side by side, it would be hard to tell them apart. Connectivity sees a subtle upgrade. Apple has enhanced the wireless stack, delivering faster Wi-Fi and 5G speeds, making cloud workflows, streaming, and collaborative tasks smoother than before. But outside of the new chip and radio improvements, most of the tablet's hardware and design remains familiar. A reliable, polished package that users already love. Pricing is another area Apple chose not to shake up. Base configurations for Wi-Fi and 5G models start at the same prices as the M4 iPad Pro, with higher storage options scaling predictably. You can also add nanotextured glass for glare reduction on the 1 TB and 2 TB models, just as before. Moving to the iPad Pro, Apple has once again prioritized consistency. The M5 iPad Pro looks and feels almost identical to the M4 version. The 13-inch model measures 11.09 by 8.48 by 0.20 inches and weighs 1.28 pounds. While the 11-inch variant is 9.83 by 6.99 by 0.21 inches and weighs just under a pound. Despite the internal upgrades, Apple has maintained the same sleek, thin aluminum frame and large glass display. The side edges hold the same USB-C port, speakers, and power volume buttons, and the rear camera remains in the upper left corner. Best of all your existing accessories, from the Apple Pencil to the Magic Keyboard, continue to work perfectly with the M5 iPad Pro. The display is also carried over from the M4. You get Apple's Ultra Retina XDR OLED technology with adaptive refresh rates from 10Hz to 120Hz, SDR brightness up to 1000 nits, HDR peak brightness of 1600 nits, True Tone for automatic white balance, P3 wide color, and an anti-reflective coating. Pixel density remains 264 pixels per inch on both sides. And if you want to reduce glare even further, nanotextured glass remains an optional upgrade for higher capacity models. Here's where the iPad Pro really steps up. The M5 chip replaces the M4, keeping a similar high-level architecture. A 9 or 10 core CPU, a 10 core GPU, and a 16 core neural engine. But everything is faster, smarter, and more efficient. Apple has added neural accelerators to the GPU, similar to the iPhone 17's A19, massively boosting AI performance. The M5 is said to be 3.5 times faster than the M4 for AI tasks, capable of handling on-device diffusion-based image generation with ease. Gaming and graphics see huge gains as well. 1.5 times faster 3D rendering with ray tracing, 6 times faster video transcoding, 4 times faster AI image generation, and up to 3.7 times faster AI video upscaling. Memory and storage are faster too. Entry models jump from 8GB to 12GB of RAM, while higher-end models keep 16GB but with quicker memory. Bandwidth increases from 120GB per second to 153GB per second, and storage read-write speeds are twice as fast, directly improving AI and app performance. Even battery and charging see improvements. Apple claims the M5 supports 50% recharge in just 35 minutes with a high-wattage USB-C charger, helping users stay productive without long interruptions. In short, while the iPad Pro's design and display feel familiar, the M5 chip transforms its performance, delivering substantial boosts in graphics, AI, and efficiency. This is more than just a spec bump. It's a true evolution in mobile computing. The M5 iPad Pro isn't just faster internally, it's smarter on the outside too. For the first time, Apple has equipped a tablet with its C1X cellular modem and N1 networking chip. The C1X modem brings 5G connectivity to the iPad Pro, leveraging the M5's efficiency to deliver double the theoretical peak speed for C-band 5G. While mmWave isn't supported, sub-6 GHz and C-band speeds are more than enough for most users. Meanwhile, the N1 combines Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and Thread radios onto a single chip. This upgrade bumps Bluetooth to 6.0 and Wi-Fi to Wi-Fi 7, future-proofing the iPad Pro and making it faster and more reliable than ever for streaming, collaboration, and smart home integration. Battery life remains largely the same as the M4 iPad Pro, around 10 hours of web browsing on Wi-Fi and 9 hours on 5G. But the M5 adds a subtle yet meaningful improvement, faster charging. With a high-wattage USB-C charger, you can recharge your tablet up to 50% in just 35 minutes, getting back to work or play much quicker than before. The camera hardware itself hasn't changed from the M4 iPad Pro. You still get a 12-megapixel rear camera with f1.8 aperture, smart HDR4, 5x digital zoom, and 4K video recording. The front camera is a 12-megapixel ultra-wide, perfect for video calls, portrait shots with bokeh, and cinematic stabilization. Where the M5 could make a difference is in its image signal processor. If it mirrors the A19 Pro chip in the iPhone 17 Pro, we can expect faster, more accurate color rendering and exposure adjustments, though we'll need side-by-side tests to confirm. For now, the M4 already delivers best-in-class tablet photography and video, so improvements will be incremental, but potentially impactful. Even without testing, it's clear that the M5 iPad Pro builds on a proven foundation. Faster CPU and GPU, improved AI, smarter radios, quicker RAM and storage, plus enhanced charging efficiency make it the more compelling choice over the M4. While the camera hardware remains the same, the upgrade image signal processor could offer subtle improvements in real-world use. All in all, the M5 iPad Pro takes the lead, offering the perfect blend of speed, efficiency, and future-ready features for both creatives and professionals. So what do we make of Apple's latest M5 chips across the MacBook Pro 14-inch and iPad Pro? For the MacBook Pro, Apple kept the familiar design, display, and ports intact, but everything under the hood is leveled up. The M5 processor delivers faster CPU and GPU performance, revolutionary AI capabilities, and snappier storage, all without compromising battery life or raising the base price. If you want a laptop that's powerful, future-ready, and compatible with your existing ecosystem, the M5 MacBook Pro is a subtle but significant upgrade. On the iPad Pro, Apple has followed a similar philosophy. The design and display remain unchanged, but the M5 chip transforms performance. CPU, GPU, and AI tasks are faster, RAM and storage bandwidth are increased, wireless connectivity is upgraded with C1X and N1 chips, and charging is quicker than ever. While the camera hardware stays the same, the improved image signal processor may bring subtle but meaningful enhancements. For creatives, professionals, and tech enthusiasts, the M5 iPad Pro takes the lead, offering a tablet experience that feels closer to a professional workstation than ever before. Ultimately, Apple's M5 generation shows that you don't always need flashy redesigns to make a meaningful difference. Performance, AI, efficiency, and connectivity upgrades are what truly matter, and Apple delivers all of them across both laptops and tablets. If you're excited by the M5 MacBook Pro or iPad Pro, now's the time to consider upgrading, especially if you rely on AI, creative workflows, or high-performance apps. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and hit the notification bell so you don't miss our upcoming in-depth hands-on tests and comparisons of the M5 devices. Drop a comment below and tell us which M5 device you're most excited to try. The MacBook Pro, the iPad Pro, or both.